Oh, hello, you insouciant long pigs. It is I, Sam of SG1, coming at you for a Transformers Transformation Review thingy, yes. And this time we are doing Studio Series 86, Perceptor. Yes, indeedy doody. I don't normally show the boxes in my reviews, but I do for the Studio Series because they're really nice. So we'll just put Percy out of the way. And we'll take a look at the box real quick. We've got some nice artwork there. Transformers, 86. I love these boxes, they're great. Some more artwork on the back there, and does things, this thing and this thing, and it comes with things, and legal slam flum flum mum, and more legal slam blah blah blah. And we've got the same image on the front there, and then we've got Transformers the movie and Perceptor. So we shall, you know, take a look at the toy. And destroyed everything. And here he is in his all his G1-y goodness. But this is a Studio Series one. Let me just adjust the camera. There we are. So yeah, this is Studio Series Perceptor. Yes, he's very nice indeed, isn't he? And he comes in his microscope mode, as you can see with your eyes. Very nice. You can do that. You can look at things, magnify things. And you can actually look through the... I don't know if this camera is going to pick it up. But you can actually see through the lens. No, you're not going to be able to see it. But you can actually see through the lens a little bit. Like on the original toy. So that's pretty cool. And he just doesn't want to fucking sit properly. There we are. And he's a Perceptor. Yeah, he's a Perceptor. He's a microscope. And he's, you know, fairly decent microscope, to be quite honest. Visible lens syndrome. And it'd be nice... Yeah, one of the big things about this toy, it'd be nice if there was a panel there that would just fill this back up a bit. But, you know, it is what it is. And he could do the thing he does in the movie where he goes like that and goes, Decepticons! You know, so, yeah, it's pretty good. Got some nice detail going on. You've even got the tank treads going in there for his third mode, which I'm not going to do because it's just basically... Do you know what? Let's do it. You, let's see if I can remember how to do it. You just lay the tank down like that. No, you don't. How do you do it? I don't think this even does it. Ah, that's it. You flip this round, flip that round, and there is the attack mode. Basically, that's it. Yeah, so it's a nothing into a nothing. So we'll just put him quickly back into microscope mode. Yeah, that's it, around like that. La 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 la. I was right the first time. No. So there he is in his microscope mode. Very nice. He's got some nice details. Got a nice tampered Autobot symbol there. Some nice details going on his what will become his chest. You've got the where you put your slides. You've got some just panel details going on. It's not really interesting. It's a microscope. You know, does what it says on the tin, really. You've got the dials there for the adjusting the magnification. Got some more technical details going on. Again, these for adjusting settings and things. So let's get into robot mode real quick. So, what do we do? Basically, we lift this up, we close this, like so. Then we come to his legs, we flip his legs out like that. Then we flip him forward, like that. And then forward again, like that. And then we bring them down, flip out his toes, and we're nearly done. So let's zoom out a bit and let's see what we're doing. There we are. So I'm just using it. It's a new stand. I'm still learning how to use it. There we are. Are you going to find your spot? There we are. So what we do is for his arms, you just basically unpeg them because there's like a little slot there and a little peg in there. Same for this side. Just unpeg them. Now what we do here is you get this side. This side just pulls out and clicks into his shoulder. This side does the same, but it's got the, so we just lift that up like that, just out of the way. We've got the same bit going on there, and you just lift it around like that. So then we lift the arms up, rotate them around, and they just should just click onto this little tab here, like so. Same for this side, there we are, rotate them around. Reach under here, bring out these little fists, which I wish they were filled in, but there you go. Pull out his little fists, there we are. And then we just stand him up. Just adjust everything, and okay. So now what we do is we flip out his head. So we just come to the back, see what I'm doing, and for some reason it's stuck in there. There we are. Pull it out, click it up, rotate it around, and we see his El Bond's face, which is nice. Then what we do is we get the cannon, rotate that on, and rotate that down, and then you click it into place, thus. And he's got his shoulder cannon, and he looks fucking cool. Perceptor, very nice indeed. I always like Perceptor. He's really cool. And let's have a look at his face there, shall we? Let's zoom this in. Let's have a look at his face. He's got a very nice face. Very G1 cartoon. That is lovely, isn't it? Very G1 cartoon. And then pissed. And then we take a look at his chest there. Very nice. So all the details carry on from microscope mode. Very nice. But that's a lovely face. That is lovely. So we'll zoom this out again. There we go. Just adjust. And then we flip back there. So in terms of articulation, his head will do 360 at the neck, move up and down, and he's got a slight waggly side to side, but nothing major. I mean, he can't look that way because he's got his cannon in the way, but I suppose he could lift it up out of the way. He's bow-legged. These don't peg in. It'd be nice if these clicked into place, but they just sort of flail out. Arms will do 360 at the shoulder. They move out. They will rotate at the bicep. They will bend a good 90 degrees at the elbow there. Nothing at the wrists, unfortunately. He can rotate at the waist, which is very nice. He can kick his leg forward. He can kick his leg backwards. He can do that. He can kick out to the side. That's more for transformation. Rotate at the top of the thigh. Bend at the knee. Gets right nice bend in the knee there. You can kick somebody right in the nuts with that. His toes will go up and down a little bit. And he's got ankle tilt for ages. So you can go like that and go, oh, I'm drunk, Optimus Prime. So there we are. He's cool, though. I do like it. It's really nice. There we go. And he has a gun. Look at his gun there. It's very nice. Very G1. And you can hold his gun in any hand you choose, but I like to put it into this hand. And you can shoot fools all day, but the Perceptor doesn't shoot that many fools. Just in the IDW comics where he's a sniper. Why a microscope should be a sniper, I don't know. A man of science wouldn't be a sniper, but there you go. But yeah, he's the scientist of the group, and he is... I like him. He's voiced by the legend that is Paul Arden. We've met a couple of times. Lovely bloke. And he's very nice indeed. I just like it. So, we come on to the box. The Studio Series box. Now, where the fuck did I put it? There it is. And he comes with a stand. You know, boom. Which is really cool. And that's the Battle of Autobot City. Or the start of the Battle of Autobot City. You know, where Ultra Magnus and everybody comes into there, and he can stand him there, and he just looks cool. He just really looks cool. You know, you can go, Ultra Magnus, a custom evaluation of Decepticon capability indicates a distinct tactical deficiency. In other words, Perceptor, we're outnumbered. You know, you can tell I've seen that movie more than once, can't you? But he can stand on there, and he can, and I love these stands, it's pretty cool. I just wish this wasn't here. It kind of interferes with the display. It doesn't need to be there. I mean, they could have put it there. You know, made this a little bit small and put it there. It just you know, interferes with the stand, the artwork a little bit. But hey ho, it is what it is, isn't it? So we'll just put Perceptor there. He's bow legged, isn't he? but yeah, it's really nice. Should you get him? Yes, you should. If you collect in the 86. Studio Series, you definitely shouldn't. You definitely need this guy. You know, he's just really nice, really cool, really fucking cool. I like it. So, if you like this review, why not tell your friends and subscribe? Hit that notification bell to tell them I've got some new content out. And if you're in a position to help out the channel, why not donate to my Patreon? I've got some, which will be up here. I've got some cool rewards over there. And you'll get not only your name shouted out into the credits, but you'll get some cool stuff to a photo gallery and other things as well. So, and check out my other Transformers reviews, which will be down here. So, thank you for watching, and I will catch you lovely, lovely, lovely sexual bastards later. Bye for now.